Welcome back, YouTubers. This is Doug with Falter Magazine on our newest episode of Building Our Pobble Facility in 2020, Episode 3. If you haven't done so already, smash the bell icon and subscribe to our channel. Every little bit helps the pobble community. This episode, we'll be discussing how we built our pole rack for our facility in our 45-foot container, which you see in this picture. Our old pole rack was too tall, too wide, too big of a gap on the bottom, and was not organized at all. Did not meet our needs. I mean, it will work, but did not fit our needs. When the school shut down and kicked us out because of the pandemic, we knew we had to get all of our poles, bars, and equipment out of there as soon as possible and get it to our new location so the kids could use it to train. So that's what we did. We loaded up our trailer and we took off with everything we had. And at that time, Derek went ahead and went home, got on SketchUp, and drew up a 3D version of the new pole rack that we're looking to build, with the heights, the widths, the lengths, and all the different pieces that he would need to build this rack himself for the kids. Derek took this project on himself, did very well, along with storage on the backhand side, and the rack turned out outstanding. The bin that we had was a rented bin, $100 a month. It was all cleaned out, ready to go, as you can see. Inside, we had some P-bars and scrap lumber and different items because it was raining outside that we wanted to keep dry. So Derek started measuring, measured twice and cut once, like they always say. Started building the legs and the different layout for everything that he needed to get this rack started and built. Throughout the day, we worked on the rack, piece by piece, taking breaks here and there to do other items around the yard, and letting kids come and jump for free during the pandemic. Later on the night, sun started going down, started putting everything together. We had no lights or anything at that time. So sun started going down, so we took and started shutting it down. Next picture, we came in first thing bright and early, 7:30 in the morning, started building more, had all four of the legs up, had two more legs to go. And this is a forward picture of all six legs supported by usually 1.5 to 2 inch wood screws with galvanized steel L brackets that we used. In the middle support brackets, we did not use any galvanized supports. We just drilled straight through with a 2 inch nail, or a 2 inch drill bit, or screw actually, wood screw. Here's another picture of the backside of Derek working, squeezing on in there. I did most of the holding, he did most of the working. In the next video, you'll see him walking around, getting some of the job done. Afterwards, we would take a break, and there's a huge wood pile next to the bin that we had to get cleared out. And as we were clearing it out, we noticed there was a dub on one end inside of a cutting device. And on the other end, we decided to go ahead and start clearing out the other end because the other end had a dub with eggs. So we took and dug it out and ran into rabbits. So it was very nice to see that Mother Nature trusted us with their animals because they weren't there from the start. The rabbits and everything kind of moved in. This big pile of dirt was relocated and tree limbs and logs were relocated, so they just built their homes there. So back to work we went. As you can see, Derek had most of the support on the sides and a few on the front. We're having to move the rack back and forth and all over the place to get all the pieces put together. We eventually took a break because we had a pit that was moving around on the platform when the kids were vaulting, so we went and got some hooks. And we took these hooks and bent them, smashed them down, and hooked them to the eyelets of the bit pieces, the pad pieces. And that kept the pad from the pit from moving around all over the place. We've had 18 six vaulters jumping on, Elite Men, Cole Walsh, and some of the others jump on this pit, and it hasn't moved at all, and it's worked very effectively. Very happy with the outcome of what we did with keeping the pit secured and drilled into that wood. Here we are looking back at the pole rack once again from the forward view. He still has some support beams to put in, but as you can see, we got most of the stuff cleaned up around both sides. We have wood down the sides. We have all the supports going in. Pretty soon it'll be time for plywood and it'll be done. As you can see, Derek has a square and he's squaring everything off and making sure it's squared away and very well built. Very proud of how he turned this thing out. On the back side of the rack, you'll notice that there is a storage facility. We ended up putting some wood down the back side of it, tightened it all up, made it look nice, and we also put a measuring device on the outside of the rack eventually so we could measure the distance of each one of the poles and mark them. Here we took our CNC machine, cut out the numbers, including the number 14 there that broke and Roman numeral 13, and this is what it looked like when it was done. Bars on the bottom, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, all the way up. And then we decided, hey, we need to get a better bin. And that's what we did. We went and found a 45-foot bin out in the middle of nowhere, $3,500 to buy it. Had rust, but it was weather tight. And this little guy, he decided to come along and give us a thrashing. He was so full of attitude. Tiny as he was, he was just raring and ready to go. He did not take any business from anybody. So after getting on playing with the goat, we decided, hey, this was the bin for us. Like I said, it was 45 feet long. The last one was actually 40 feet long, so we got an extra 5 feet. We thought that would come in handy when we built the office and we built the tool room and we built the pole rack. So eventually in these videos, we'll go down each one of those different aspects of the build. Here, they're backing in the 45 footer, did an exceptionally good job. It was $3,500, like I said, delivered. They delivered the darn thing right next to the concrete, nice and easy and professional like they've done a billion times. As you can see, the concrete on the left, we just moved our gear a little bit out of the way. And at this point, we owned the box so we could take and do what we wanted with it. And that was the good thing about it. So if we wanted to cut it, paint it, adjust it, whatever else we wanted to do, move it to a new location, eventually we could. And this is where it stood. The doors weren't that great in the front, but eventually you'll see we cut them off. And we took it.